Welcome back. Our next guest is the brains behind a full-blown phenomenon. Jenny Han is the New York Times bestselling author of the book series To All the Boys I've Loved Before.
In 2018, Netflix turned the first book into a hit film, and now the sequel is dropping tomorrow.
It's good stuff. It picks up with main character Lana Condor facing new questions about her love life.
Having a boyfriend meant the mere idea of other boys left your mind completely. And yet, here I was, totally crazy about Peter, but I couldn't stop replaying my conversation with John Ambrose in my head.
I didn't care about everyone.
I didn't want to be thinking about what might have been if he had gotten that letter in middle school instead of now. But I was.
I love these kind of movies.
Yes, the
actor,
you do.
You said the actor looks
He's
like your
so
first
cute.
Boyfriend?
I mean, this is, kids love
he
these.
He resembled your first boyfriend?
Moving on. Jenny, hello.
Yes.
Here's the thing. How cool is it that you've had this, you know, this idea for a book? There's so many people who are authors and want to write, but now it's so successful, and now on Netflix, and people love it.
It's so surreal. I mean, I think the book audience is much smaller and more intimate, mm-hmm. and then being on Netflix, it just goes global
yeah.
in a much bigger way because everyone watches it at the same time.
And the concept is fun.
You know, it's funny. You're a friend of the show. You've been on a number of times talking about other books, and we always love it when you come by. I did not know until a few minutes ago that you were actually a librarian.
Yes, I was.
How did that job inform the writing, inform the perspective that you have now?
I was a school librarian, so I was around kids all day. I think I was, like, the mean librarian.
I'd be
like,
shh.
I don't believe that.
Like, guys, be chill.
Yeah.
They always be sneaking food. But I think that I tend to write stories about teens in the suburbs and, like, smaller towns. And so I think these city kids have a different way of life because they have every, like, museum and, like, show and
stuff. At their footsteps,
yeah.
Your fingertips.
Yeah, yeah, you're already filmed the third one, the third installment of this, and you were in Korea. Mm-hmm. And it turns out Parasite had just such a great moment at the Oscars, and there was a 6 degrees of separation between you and the director of Parasite.
So our PA, who drove us around.
Your production assistant.
Yes, sorry. Yeah. Hollywood lingo that I now use. I was talking about Parasite and how amazing it is, and I was like, he's gonna win an Oscar. This is last summer too. We hadn't hit here yet.
Wow.
And then I was talking to the other producer about it, and for like 30 minutes, and then he doesn't say anything. He just goes, oh, is he famous in America? I go, oh yeah, he's famous.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, we go, what does your dad do? And he was like, oh, he's a director. And then it was
exactly.
His son. Yeah.
That's
right?
Cool.
Wow.
Yeah.
So I want to set up the premise of why this is so popular. So let me see if I'm explaining it correctly. So in the book, a girl is writing pretend love letters to her crushes, so to speak, and then someone sends them out. Was it her sister?
Little sister?
Her little sister.
Yes.
We don't want to give away too much.
Yes. Spoiler alert. So, yes, it was her sister.
Okay. But I didn't know what I could give away.
They weren't really pretend. I mean, it was like she put out all her true, deepest feelings
on the
page. I used to do it. That's how I got the idea for it.
You did this?
I did it. I did it. I wrote love letters when I was trying to find closure and put it all on the page like a diary. I put it in a hat box. I did not send them.
Nobody sent them to anybody.
Thank God, no.
Oh, okay. That's
so then did you just get the idea, what if that were to happen?
What if? Exactly.
Ah. And the rest is history.
And the rest is history.
Have you ever thought about sending out those love letters?
Never.
whatever happened to the boy? Whatever happened to the boy?
No. I mean, I will say, I thought it would be really funny on my book tour if I read from one of the letters.
Would he know?
No, but then the first night I did it, everyone was laughing and loving it, and my face was just so red. I was so embarrassed, and I realized, actually, what you feel as a teen still really resonates as an adult.
Yes, it does. I can attest to that.
I think that's why people love it so much. It's the concept of
We're
it.
So
it's
happy
relatable.
For your success.
Thank you.
So, to all the boys, P.S., I still love you. It premieres tomorrow on Netflix.